you know, Jen is complicated, but to use her name knowing it would get more exposure for what you're writing is disgusting. Like, stay away from me. Like, why are you so desperate to be in this friend group?
Hi, baby gorgeous.
Hi. So cute. Henry's always like, that's my name. Why is everybody saying baby gorgeous? And I'm like, Henry's jealous.
It has fully become your quote. People love it. I love it. We love it.
Did you see at BravoCon, like I walked in and the big sign, hi, baby gorgeous. And I'm like, oh, here, I'm ready. So I can't imagine what you felt seeing that.
Oh no, it was so amazing. I literally took so many videos with John. I'm like, I can't even believe, you know, when you say things, you don't think anything of it. It's just like, hey, I'm talking to Henry. So to see that up there, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is really real. Like all of it. It's crazy.
So fun. Wait, I love that you're wearing the fur, Lisa. It's very Salt Lake. It's very just like bringing us right into the moment. I love it.
It's so cold in Park City right now in Salt Lake City. And then yesterday when I flew into New York, it was freezing. Today's actually a really nice day, but I'm like furs, big coat.
So glamorous. Well, speaking of Park City, Salt Lake, man, this season 3, already so much. And it does seem like you're kind of in the center of a lot of the drama this season.
Yes.
How are you feeling about that?
You know, going into season 3, I knew it was going to be different, like just based off the reunion, you know, with the hot mic moment. And I don't know if you guys watched What Happens Live last night, but really,
yes, I died.
I know. I was like, oh my gosh, this is so amazing. And I'm cringing so hard because I'm like, you know, the way he said all of my words, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's easier to hear fast.
I'm offended by that. F*** you. That f***ing piece of garbage whore. I f***ing hate her. She's a whore. She's f***ed half of New York. She can go f*** herself.
Amazing, you know, Oscar nominee saying like my hot mic moment, I died. I literally died. So with that said, going into season 3 was a little crazy because I'm like, no one knew that was going to air. I didn't even know it was going to air. I didn't know I was recorded. I had no idea. And then you hit the reunion and we were filming while the show was airing. So 2 weeks after we filmed the reunion, we still had another like 7 weeks of airing. And so we were filming. So season 3, I went into and I'm like, I don't know how this is going to work out because, you know, we didn't leave on a pretty note. You know what I mean? Like the reunion was rough.
It was very rough. I have to say your choir audition was so good. It is so, all those people posting about how you got Grammy nominated had me cracking up. Were you nervous?
To audition? No, yeah. Not really. But you know what? When you're filming the show, you forget that like the whole world's going to see it. So I had to sing, Oh, When the Saints Come Marching In, Away in a Manger. And I didn't really feel nervous until I walked in and I saw the panel of judges. So one of the guys that was there, his dad's like an iconic singer based out of Utah. And he's like kind of a big deal in Utah. So I'm like, oh my gosh, his son's here. He like trains so many amazing people vocally. So I'm like, I used to sing when I was younger, but I'm like, I haven't sang in a long time. My range is like so different now. And so all of a sudden it started to hit me like, oh my gosh, like there's like real people that can sing judging me. And I think there was like a moment I felt nervous. And I think it was awkward too, because like, you know, Heather and I didn't talk because I like called out a lie. So I didn't know how she was going to react. But I sing all the time in my car and shower, just not for everybody else.
I mean, it's like now one of the most iconic moments. I think I can say this, most iconic moments in Housewife history. Yeah. It was so funny. It was so funny. No. But I also loved, you went there to show your support for Heather, even though you guys weren't at a good place. Where do you guys stand today? Where do you stand with Heather?
Heather and I are complicated. Like I said, we kind of need a 12-step program for our friendship. And I think with Heather, my biggest thing is like, I'm like, be honest, because, you know, all the lies are like a house of cards and they're going to crumble. And I feel like when Heather's like honest and authentic in our friendship, I feel like we're great. It's just when there's like these little like lies told. And I think for me and Heather, like Heather likes to narrate everyone and put words in their mouth. So I'll say one thing and she repeats it back to me a totally different way where she's all of a sudden the victim. And I think that for me, I understand Heather, like I'm able to move forward with anyone that wants to. I don't think we're in a bad place. I don't think we're in a great place. I just think Heather and I are in the same place we always are.
Right. So you just kind of have to sit in that gray with some people sometimes. Like not every housewife is going to be best friends or enemies. You know, it's just that gray space.
Yeah, it's that gray space. And like, I'm fine with it. Like, you know, Heather can make me laugh. Heather and I can have a lot of fun together. And Heather just likes being committed to having an issue with me. I think it's funny. Like even we were on the same flight on the way to BravoCon and we were laughing together. But I'm super direct. I grew up in New York. So we just say what we're thinking. You've heard me say like the bad truth's better than a good lie. And I think Heather's comfortable in a space where like, I think a lot of girls in Utah, I'm going to typecast a little here, think if they're nice to your face, it doesn't matter what they do behind your back. And I think like, once you figure out like both matter, then it changes everything. But we had a great time on the way to BravoCon and then got on a panel together and then it goes downhill.
Oh my God. Lisa, you guys went off. You gave the fans what they wanted. I will say that. That was like the best panel.
It was all raw. Like, I don't think anyone thought it was going to go that direction. And I think for me, where Heather triggers me a little bit, where I want to call her out is, I'm like, don't pretend you or anyone else is the victim when you know what you're saying behind scenes on camera that doesn't air, you know? And I think that's what's complicated about reality TV. There's a lot that happens that you either don't see or don't see everything of. So, but that panel was intense.
That panel was intense. I can only imagine what was going through your mind, because also, you know, Meredith, you and Meredith were on the panel together. And I think I talked to you right before you did the panel and yes, you guys were like, did. Yeah. And it was still, we haven't really talked after the panel. Where are you guys now?
You know, I just think that for me and Meredith, I don't really know, because I thought when we left Arizona, we were in a much better place. I feel like once Whitney came out with the facts that everybody had been talking about me and my marriage behind my back, and I didn't even realize until watching episode one that they were talking about one of my businesses too. So that was very interesting to me. And I felt like when we left Arizona, there was clarity, like you're retaliating, we're tit for tat. And you know, if you go eye for an eye with everyone, everyone's going to be blind. And I feel like, you know, after we left Arizona, it was kind of like a great place. We all went to dinner together. Meredith and I were fine on the van. It wasn't until, you know, we were at auditions that I realized like, oh, Meredith is still very, I thought we made a lot of headway in Arizona. Right. And then at auditions, I'm like, nope, she actually raised her hand when I said, who here doesn't want to be my friend? She was one of the three.
Did we see that on camera? It was, we just saw. And
you did not, but she definitely raised her hand. And I was like, wow. And I think she was upset that Whitney had, after she got home and thought about it, I think she was upset that Whitney outed her for talking badly behind my back. And there was stuff done off camera too. It wasn't just what you see on camera.
We need to talk about the other complicated issue that's going on is Angie's husband's fake Instagram account. I don't know. I was watching that last week and I was like, wait, what?
It's so cringy. It's so crazy. You know, I was so disgusted. I started seeing comments on Instagram and I'm like, nobody's that vested in me or my relationship with Angie. It has to be the Harringtons. And my cousin's like young and really cool and like kind of like a TikTok like fan. She's a hack on TikTok and she reverse looked it up and she's like, it's for sure Chris Harrington. I mean, it was proven. And it wasn't when we were still airing. She was on Twitter saying some comments.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, don't think we don't know about your husband's fake accounts. And then everybody on Twitter was like, her husband has fake accounts. And this is like basically last year. And then you know, when he fessed up to it, I'm like, that's great. But I think they both did it together. I think it's super cringy. And I don't understand what their commitment to hating me is. Like, I was a great friend to Angie. She made up this whole lie about me canceling her caterers. And
which is, by the way, it's just old. I'm so tired of hearing it. Like,
it's like, stay away from me. Like, why are you so desperate to be in this friend group and just keep purporting lies about me? She started some of the rumors about my marriage. And like, I've never confided in Angie. I'm not cheating on John. And it was like the person they named is a very close friend of ours and a business partner. So that could damage a business relationship. And it was irresponsible and disgusting. But, you know, I feel like they're like fixated on me a little bit. And her whole birthday trip in Mexico was spent talking ill of me. We knew people that were on that trip with them. And they're like, all they did was bash you for 5 days straight. And she took strangers basically on her 40th birthday trip. Why would you do that? It's very strange. But the whole fake Instagram account, I could not be married to someone that would do that. And I would never encourage or sit by John doing that. My husband would never do that. My husband barely gets on Instagram. Like,
no, it's like so upsetting, especially in this world of online bullying. Like, it's so not cool. It should be completely not okay. You know,
the fact that they wouldn't stop is what's really disconcerting to me. Walked away and I'm like, you know what? I'm not interested. I'm not interested in a relationship with you anymore. The fact that you could lie about me, but to lie about me and then bully me online. You know, like what was one of the URLs on one of their fake account pages? I believe there's more than one, Mary's Apostles, and the URL was lisasliesmatter.com. And I'm like, I'm not the one lying. And, you know, you work for a company. I'm sure you have women employees. I don't even know how he can manage women, because I'm like, I don't know any grown men in a leadership position that could bully a woman online. It blew my mind. And even using Jen Shah's name when she's, you know, Jen is complicated, but to use her name, knowing it would get more exposure for what you're writing, is disgusting. And I don't want them ever around me again. I think they're just very bad people.
Yeah.
It's just wrong on so many levels. Yeah. And you just brought up Jen. And I do want to know, because a lot of people were talking at BravoCon, including Andy, kind of speculating that she's probably not going to return next season. What do you think? Do you think she should return, or what's your thoughts on that?
You know, that's above my pay grade, but I think that when Andy made the announcement that they've parted ways for Jen, I think that's the answer right there. But I think Jen has much bigger things to worry about. Fame, I don't think should be, being a part of a TV show shouldn't be a priority. But it's Jen's life. And I haven't really spoken to Jen since we wrapped. We exchanged Mother's Day pleasantries, you know, this year. But I haven't really talked to her. She's been really nasty online, just writing really rude things about everyone on our cast, except for two people. So, you know, I think Jen has bigger things to deal with than being on a TV show.
Totally.
Yeah.
Lisa, we love catching up with you. You are just so much fun. You make me laugh on every episode, even when you don't mean to. So
you guys are the cutest. You both look beautiful.
And thank you.
Thanks for having me today. And it was so good to see you, Lauren, at BravoCon. I wish I got to see you too.
Yes.